about why to do a thing like that in a small country like Denmark. But we have a long tradition for planting, and it all started with Johann von Langen, who actually came from Germany, and he was asked by the Danish king, Frederick V, to come to Denmark. So he came, and with him a huge import of species started. Denmark is special in the sense that we only have one native conifer, which is Pinus sylvestris. All the rest, they are aliens or they are imported, but grow usually very well. You see here a nice example of Betula coming from Sweden, and a very bad one, provenance of Fagus of Beech from Romania. Also, as a collaboration between the university and the Forest Service, there have been lots of field trials and provenance testing among the most important species. What did we do before the web portal to tell people about the provenances and the best material? The Forest Service, the place where I'm employed, we made these seed source descriptions, which you can ask to get. And we make them every year, and whenever there are new knowledge, they are reviewed. And also we made the paper form of the web portal, you can say, because in that we try to put all the information together to tell people seed sources to use on which localities. But then we figure out that it might be a good idea to make this web portal, which was interactive. And it's public available and it's free, and you can be guided and help to select the best plant material depending on what you want to plant and where you want to plant. The portal consists of two components. There is a database of knowledge which basically contains all the information we have about the different seed sources. And then there is a recommendation function where guidelines are given, and you can also see recommendations for seed sources. There is a guideline to selection of species, there is recommendations for provenances and selected material, and that would only be for the seed producing. You will not see a seed source which is not mature, you can say. Also, in the web portal, information is available on where you can buy the different provenances, which nursery you can go to ask for the different seed sources. The main entrance is the map of Denmark. And you click on the map, wherever you want to plant, you click here, or you click here, or wherever. And then you are asked about certain things about the locality. You are asked whether it's, how is the soil, is it moist? Do you have problems with wind, and do you have problems with frost? Because that's the three main things which is important in our country. Late frost in spring, for example, that can be very harmful. So it's important to know if that's a problem on the locality where you want to plant. And then there is, if you look here, that's the different entrances to the systems. You can enter here, that's the species recommendations. You can enter here. That's the seed source recommendations. You can also have this, which is the way to enter if you want to plant with a subsidy, and this if you only want to know where to buy the plants. We have divided the country in 13 zones based on climatic data and soil data. And of course it's a rough grid, and that was the detailed level we could reach. And as you will see, many of the seed sources, they can be used in several zones. Then there is the ranking, and we operate with the A, B, C, D, E and F categories. And when you have given the locality and you ask what species can I plant here, you will get this ranking. The species ranked in category A are the best, the one in B are the second best, the one in C is the third best, and so forth. We have tried to make it user-friendly in the sense that you can always, wherever you are in the system, you can click here, and you are told what is you are expected to do at that certain page. So you can be guided through if it's not self-evident what you're going to do. One can ask why to make such a system, but we thought that it wasn't important to give people, also those who wasn't employed in forestry or within a nursery, a possibility to select the best material. And also it was a way of getting knowledge public available, and again to try and get the best material out in the forests and landscapes. How was the system made? It was made as a collaboration between a major agency, University of Copenhagen, and it included a lot of computer work, but also a lot of collection of data. Many of the data are from a time where the computer was very young, so they have to be found and put into the system. Who do what? The university, they make the species and seed source recommendations based on the available knowledge. While we have the maintenance of the general maintenance of the system. What have we learned so far? We've learned that it takes time and still refinements are needed. When we launched the portal, we thought that, this is pretty good. But it soon turned out that refinements were needed. There's also a trade-off between details and complexity versus the user-friendliness. To say that as a forester or as a researcher, you want to put as much knowledge into the system as possible. But it can be, you can make it so complicated that it will not be user-friendly anymore. So there's a trade-off. And also we learned that not all like the system, because with the system it becomes very clear where your seed source are ranked. And in Denmark there are both public and private seed source owners. And with this system you cannot kind of hide where your seed sources are ranked. It's pretty evident. And that gave not problems, but debate. And one way to try to deal with that was to have this transparency. For example, to make the criteria evident, you can click here, and you'll have this where you can read what is the criteria for the general ranking. Also, we have made this, it's not a kind of lock, but still, you are, as a user, you can get a password and a username, and you can log in, and you can say, well, this is very nice, this ranking, but in my spot, when I live there and there, and I see that actually the one that you rank C, it grows very nicely at my property, or something like that. So this block, with this block you can also put in your comments. But also we have realized that with the system, people only want the A categories, provenances or species. And we have a job there to say to people that yes, A is best, but B, it doesn't mean that B necessarily is a directly bad choice. It's not as good as A, but it might still be okay. Because one thing, and especially with the forestry, is that seeds are not available every year. So we will turn into situations where the best provenances are actually not available. And that has also been one of the things that we had to deal with.